Hello and welcome to the player prop video for Sunday Night Football. We got the Indianapolis Colts at Dallas Cowboys. I'm your host, Matthew Motto for Lifestyle. I'm joined here by Jacob Blaine, Jason Gilbo, and we have just an absolute barn burner of a matchup with the Jeff Saturday-led Colts as 10.5-point underdogs on the road in Dallas. Just a great way to cap a beautiful slate of games is being able to go to bed early and not watching this game. But, Jacob, I know you said despite hating this matchup, you have a couple plays you like, so go ahead.
Yeah, nothing on the game picks side for me, but a couple player props I do like here. The first is just going to be CeeDee Lamb over receiving yards. Pretty simple. I just think he's quietly maybe a top 5-6 wide receiver in the league right now, honestly. I think he doesn't get talked about that way, but he's been fantastic this season. He has 94 targets and only 4 drops. He's averaging just under 90 receiving yards since Dak Prescott came back, and that's despite some of these games just being pure blowouts. And he's a great matchup here. He plays a lot of his snaps out of the slot. And looking at Kenny Moore playing in the slot for the Colts, out of slot corners with at least 150 coverage snaps, Kenny Moore is allowed the second highest passer rating in the slot. He's somebody we've looked to target a little bit recently in some of these other games. And yeah, I just think CeeDee Lamb's going to eat. And also, I think the Colts can limit the Cowboys' rushing offense quite a bit. They rank 11th in run defense DVOA, 7th in tackling, 5th in yards per carry allowed. And you look at the DVO rankings of some of the teams that the Cowboys have faced. Since week 5, you have, I think, 6 teams who are below the 20th best team in DVOA against the run, and the Colts are significantly better than that. So I don't think the Cowboys will be quite as effective on the ground in this game. I think they're going to have to throw the ball even when they're up here. And I think CeeDee Lamb has a fantastic matchup, and he should just be able to take advantage.
Yeah, I think that's fair, and it's interesting because I feel like the dialogue the first 3 weeks of the season where CeeDee Lamb can't be a wide receiver one, and it seems like that dialogue quickly went away even with Cooper Rush at quarterback, and now that Dak's back, it's not there. And it seems like everyone who was saying that, there's no backtracking. They just kind of pretended like they never said in the first place. So I'm going to call him out a little bit and maybe call myself out a little bit because I'm definitely much higher on him right now than I was at the beginning of the season. I also think he's just getting better. He's still a really young player, just like every wide receiver from that stacked class. Jason?
The one I'm looking at is it would be under Jonathan Taylor receptions in this spot. It's not out yet, but it's been casually sitting at 2.5, the over-under the last few weeks. I mean, obviously, Hines has been gone. It hasn't shifted a ton his way. I mean, he's basically kind of been around the 1, 2, 3, 4 mark for receptions this season. 4 targets each of the last 2 games. He did have 3 receptions. He is obviously going to get dump-offs under pressure. But Dallas's athleticism, I think, just does enough compared to where we've seen the linebacking corps the last few games, where they've just allowed just such minimal, you know, production in terms of receptions and receiving yards. Like, I would look at both, but I just feel like he does have that capability of breaking one off. But Dallas 10th in DVOA against running backs. Like I said, I think their linebacking core is extremely competent of kind of focusing on Taylor, especially in the passing game. And like I said, I just think overall this offensive line is going to put them in so much trouble where I know we look at safety for running backs and dump offs, but I just don't think that'll be the case here. He's just been flirting with this number. I think you'll actually get a decent value on it because I think the juice will be on the over a little bit because he has hit this in a couple games. Tour, I think the under stands out quite a bit here for me, especially with that probably focus more on getting him involved on the ground and getting other backs, as we've seen kind of lately, more involved in the passing game.
Yeah, that's... I'm not going to push back because I think you're right. I'm just a little nervous playing it at such a low line, but I feel like your logic's there and it definitely should hit. But again, we'll see where the line even comes out. We could get lucky and have a nice line or at least some plus odds on that 2.5 on the under. Jacob, I was going to go back to you. I guess I didn't even take a prop myself. I don't know, man. Like, you guys were talking about how bad this game was in a Bang Picks video. I feel like there's some value on the player props, but there's nothing right now that I'm looking at for what DK has, what's available. And again, you can check out all the player props on Lamps.com on the player prop page where you can compare odds across multiple sportsbooks. There's nothing that I've seen that's just jumping out to me, which is rare. I'm usually, you know, playing quite a bit, trying to spread out my units. And I don't know, I love Paris Campbell. I just don't want to bet anything on this Colts team right now. So, Jacob, I am just going to throw it back to you.
I'm going to take Jonathan Taylor, longest rush over 16 and a half. I think if you want to take his flat rushing yardage prop thing, that's fine too. I think it's a touch low at 76 and a half, but I like the longest rush here just because of how bad the Cowboys have been in terms of allowing explosive runs. You know, we do see them, their defense giving up a lot of that, and they're ranked 29th in explosive rush defense, allow the fifth most yards before contact to running backs. And you know, when you get Jonathan Taylor with some yards before contact and ahead of his team, I think he can rip off some long runs. We've seen that more recently with him. Prior to last week's game, he had gone over this number in three straight, including a 68-yard run to the house against the Raiders that really highlighted that talent that he so clearly has. It's just been a tough year for him, but part of that is because the Colts have faced the fifth toughest schedule of run defenses so far. So, frankly, this Cowboys defense should be kind of a breath of fresh air for him, and I think the Colts can do enough to keep it close, at least early on, and maybe even the second half, too, but at least enough to make it so Jonathan Taylor is getting touches in this game. I mean, we've seen him get 20-plus carries in, I think, three straight now, so I'm not overly concerned about the game script limiting his ability to hit this, but I think just getting this isolated play, one long run, I think he should be able to get that done against this defense.
Yeah, I think that's kind of the safe way to go, especially if this game gets out of hand. Again, we saw it with the Vikings game. We just saw how talented this Dallas Cowboys team and how quickly they can get on you with how good they are. So I don't want to take Jonathan Taylor over 76.5 when I'm kind of nervous if he's still going to be running the ball in the second half. But for him to just get one carry over 16, I'm for it.
Yeah, the one pushback I would have on that is the Cowboys just dominated the Vikings in that game with their running backs. And, I mean, we've seen that repeatedly. Jordan Hicks is maybe the worst player in coverage in space against running backs this season, like in the league. So I don't quite see that happening in this game. I think the Colts' defense is quietly pretty good. So I think it'll stay close enough throughout that Jonathan Taylor can hit the over on his total rushing yards. But I often like kind of isolating it here when you can really bank on Jonathan Taylor getting just like one explosive run to hit this.
I mean, I don't think you're wrong, and I think that is a likely scenario. It's more of, I like almost eliminating the factor altogether with the long by just taking the longest rush. Jason?
There's nothing else here for me. I'm done.
I'm sorry that this video is so depressing, if you're watching it, but man, like, this game is depressing, so there's not much I can tell you.
If the NFL would have just put Bengals Chiefs or Niners Dolphins or even Raiders Chargers on primetime,
I would have taken.
We would have had some more plays, man. But what are you gonna do?
Jags Lions.
I'll take Jags Lions. That's gonna be a great game.
Kidding around.
It'll be more entertaining game.
Oh man! All right. So our player prop: CeeDee Lamb over 72.5 receiving yards at -115 for Jacob. Over 16.5 longest rush for Jonathan Taylor at -115 for Jacob. Jason's going to be under Jonathan Taylor receptions in this game, and I'm going to be asleep during this game. So that's going to wrap it up for this one. Thank you guys for watching. As always, if you liked this video, drop a like. If you did not, a dislike. Comment down below your favorite bets. Don't forget to check out the Bang Picks version of this show where we went over spread, money line, and the over-under, as well as some of the other team bets like halves, quarters, and all that good jazz. Hit the subscribe button if you want more great content like this. Check out lineups.com to get more betting analysis, and you can also use our great tools like our snap counts page and such to get some more information to make better betting decisions. All right, we will see you for the next one. Very soon.